Its first policy decision for the year, the Philippine Central Bank kept its benchmark rate unchanged at 6.5%. That is a near 17-year high in what it called a prudent move amid prevailing risks to inflation. The BSP, though sounding less hawkish this time, did lower their inflation outlook for the year to just 3.9%, already within government's target range of 2-4%.
In consideration of the prevailing risks, the Monetary Board deems it appropriate to keep the BSP's monetary policy settings unchanged in the near term amid the improvement in inflation conditions. The BSP also continues to support the national government's non-monetary measures to address supply-side pressures on prices and sustain the disinflation process.
The Philippine gaming regulator debunking false reports on the agency's privatization plans. A social media post by an employee alleges PAGCOR is planning to spend some 500 million pesos to renovate its casino branch in Angeles City, Pampanga. But the agency clarifies the lessor, and not PAGCOR, will shoulder the renovation cost as part of privatization. PAGCOR also belied reports about some 10,000 employees losing their jobs in the privatization efforts, saying 10,000 is actually their total workforce already, and that the agency is only shutting off its casino operations, but many workers will remain and stay on to do regulatory enforcement, monitoring, and electronic gaming licenses. The privatization of PAGCOR casinos will begin in the last quarter of 2025. The Philippine Senate set to approve a bill pushing for an across-the-board wage hike, but their House counterparts aren't sure the Filipinos will benefit from the measure. RG Cruz tells us more.
This early, the House of Representatives is already studying the Senate's proposal for a 100 peso legislated wage hike for workers. This House leader explains they do not want to raise false hopes because aside from the amount being too low, small and medium-sized businesses may not be able to afford it. It's a sentiment first bared by the top economists of the House last Monday.
The marching orders of the Speaker and the leaders of the House, gawin ang lahat para maibsan ang hirap ng buhay ng bawat pamilyang Pilipino. Pero kakibat doon, yung gagawin mo ang totoong mangyayari, hindi yung paasa lang. Ang takot natin doon, baka yung 10 empleyado ay maging 7 na lang. No? So yun yung medyo dapat natin i-balance.
Kaya lang kasing iwalayin yung mga malalaking kumpanya. Pwede sana yun eh. Ikaso tatawanan yan SMEs eh, mamamatay lahat yun eh. Kasi hindi nila kakayanin eh. Hindi nila talaga kakayanin. Kumbaga, 99% ng lahat ng enterprise natin, SMEs.
A business leader raises a similar concern.
Lalo na mga yung micro, hirap-hirap na magbito sweldo nila. Even na, tataas mo ng 25% yung sweldo. Hindi kaya. Yun naman mga malalaki eh. Hindi mo naman kailangan sabihin pa yan eh. Mahigit pa rin ang binibigay ng sweldo ng mga yun.
Senate leaders, however, believe this is a step in the right direction.
The business sector has enough buffer to absorb the cost. Yeah. It's not the question if will they make money. Yes, they will still continue to make money, but it's how much money they will make. So we have to also moderate the greed when it comes to large corporations. Because micro, small, medium enterprises will not be that affected. Under the CREATE law, the taxes, corporate income taxes of micro, small, and medium enterprises was brought down to 20%. Yeah. So from 33% to 20%, they have a 13% tax cut from their income tax. Uh-oh. Kaya naman nila yun.
The Senate is expected to approve the proposed bill on third and final reading on Monday with the hope that the lower house will immediately tackle the measure. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Ayala Malls has set aside 13 billion pesos to give 4 of its flagship malls in the Philippines a makeover. But that's not all, as the company's officials say more luxury brands are coming to the country as the renovations progress. Jackie Pascual gives us a look.
Ayala Malls is spending 13 billion pesos to renovate 4 of its major malls in Metro Manila and Cebu as part of efforts to improve the mall experience of Filipinos. This amid the rise of online shopping and new technologies. Greenbelt and Glorieta in Makati, Trinoma in Quezon City, and Ayala Center Cebu will undergo what they call reinvention to improve the overall design, expand green spaces, and enhance access for commuters and motorists.
This is the first time in our history that we will embark on renovating at least four of our major flagship malls at once. So almost 400,000 square meters in gross leasable area, significant investment.
We're looking at everything from our websites, our customer loyalty app, car parking, wayfinding. The more we can do to encourage them to dwell with us longer, and that has a positive sustainable benefit for our tenants as well.
They will also improve its digital platform and add QR codes around the mall after learning that customers tend to get lost in their malls.
We've heard a lot from customers and experienced ourselves the challenge of getting through some of our bigger malls, within the mall, just finding your way through the mall.
Okay. Getting lost in
getting
the maze.
Getting lost in the mall.
That's
so
a
I think,
70s
yeah.
design, by the way.
Well, I think, you know, I think our app, the Ayala Mall Zing app, has done a lot to help that.
A traffic impact study is also in the works as they plan to close off some roads in Glorieta and integrate the two small parks nearby into the mall.
We've got to understand how that flows, how the urban traffic control works. You can have had the best day in the world, but if you then spend 3 hours waiting to pay your 20 pesos to get out, it completely ruins the impacts.
He adds they may put up a Palawan cherry orchard garden in one of the malls to have a feel of Japan's cherry blossoms. This will further enhance the shopping experience as more luxury brands are expected to set up shop in the Philippines.
With Greenbelt 3 and 4 renovations, we saw an increase in demand from what we call heritage luxury brands. So these are the likes of Louis Vuitton, Dior, Fendi, Loewe. Most of them that we're planning for don't exist in the country today.
Officials say the malls will not be closed during the renovation as it will be done in stages, which is expected to be completed between 2026 and 2028. Other Ayala malls and Seda hotels will also undergo minor renovations. It also expects to welcome back Mandarin Oriental in about 2 years. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Marketing giant iFern wants the stigma against the networking industry removed. This is iFern, which uses this model to sell vitamins, claims Filipinos have wrong preconceived notions about direct selling and network marketing. The firm notes the networking industry is an emerging global industry and was able to provide jobs to people during the height of the COVID pandemic when most people were out of work.
Sa Philippines, pyramiding, networking, direct selling, isang word lang yan. Yeah. Tapos dagdag mo pa yung fourth word, scam. Mm. Pag sinabing direct selling, networking, scam yan. No? So I always answer that. And, you know, unfortunately, it's such a big global industry. But the Filipino, they like to listen to the advice of the lolo, lola, kapitbahay, kumpare, classmate, katrabaho. So, ay, yung kumpare ng lolo nung barkada ko na kapitbahay namin, naloko sa networking, huwag kang papasok. You know, during pandemic, when all of the OFWs and the seamen were forced to return home, we were able to give good business to a lot of people, especially during pandemic.